Welcome to August the 12th. Today it's my off-camera day because it's hot, it's sticky, and I don't want to bother putting up some lights just for that. So we are talking about what has happened just a few days ago, which also coincidentally was a bunch of balance tuning to some specs. We had a few buffs. We will look into the effect they had to the specs being buffed, as well as, of course, the nerf to the five more popular and dominating specs in Mythic Plus. So let's just go and take a look. Yeah, let's just go and look at what is changing, if anything, what is changing in the performance, in the power of these specs after this balance tuning. We mentioned before we go ahead, when we looked at the changes, that likely the more affected specs were going to be Holy Paladin and Shadow Priest, mostly due to the size of their nerfs. Now, looking over at Mythic Plus isn't really telling us much, at the very least up to now. The nerfs were, in case you forgot, they were some 10% AoE damage nerfs to Fire Mage, some 3-4% nerfs to the single target of Shadow Priest, and some 7% AoE damage nerfs to Shadow Priest as well, some less damage of Guardian Druid, as well as an overall carpet bomb nerf to Holy Paladin, both to their damage as well as to their healing. We forwarded a few days ago the possibility, for example, of specs like Discipline to be taking over Holy Paladin, perhaps something like Fire Mage switching over to another mage spec, or perhaps another spec like Destro, maybe Balanced Druid, or even Red Paladin, just to keep the utility of a Paladin in your group if you replace Holy. For now, for the moment, nothing really is changing. Then again, it's just been a few days, but yeah, we continue to see more or less the same popularities we have seen up to and before this patch, with basically the same comps at the basically the same power level as before. So at the very least, the dream of seeing something change in Mythic Plus for now isn't really happening. Of course, the specs are weaker, but then again, it matters more how much more powerful they were from the rest of the specs. Because if Fire Mage was 30% better than Balance, if you nerf them by 10%, well, they are still 20% better, so it's not really gonna make them move away. However, what we mentioned about a few times already is that the situation in the raid is more even, is more balanced than the situation in Mythic Plus. Because where things in Mythic Plus might, at the end of the day, still remain with this unchanged S tier for the next couple of months, we might have a few changes when it comes to the raid already, even just, you know, 3-4 days after the release of this patch. Because, looking at the raid, first of all, we have a quite handy new feature from Warcraft Logs, which has gracefully decided to split the performances after the patch. After this reset, we get a brand new set of logs for the performance. And the first thing you notice, of course, is the fact that Shadow Priest is now even further down the bottom. As we pointed out, Shadow Priest was nerfed in their damage once more in this patch, so now they are falling even further down in terms of overall DPS. And of course, their single target damage has fallen even further down. We mentioned the main weakness of Shadow Priest being the single target, so the nerf to Shadow Priest, which was to a few things they use in single target, like Shadowy Apparitions or like Vampiric Touch, of course, made them even weaker, and overall, they are still not really that well performing, which is a difference, right? It's a difference from what we have just seen in Mythic Plus, where even after the nerfs, at the very least for now, we're not really seeing any changes when it comes to their power. In the raid, though, it's definitely more visible. The other more visible thing, perhaps, is the fact that now Outlaw Rogue has spiked up by quite a bit. This is just a matter of maths. You know, Outlaw, previously, the last time we looked at this was basically here, was basically where Shadow Priest was. The median DPS was 117,000, but they were buffed by 5%. Now, children, what is the 5% of 117,000? Well, the 5% is roughly 5.5k. So, if you increase the Outlaw Rogue damage from 117,000 by 5.5k, they should be around 122,500. Where is Outlaw now? Outlaw is at 122,300. So it's a 5% increase, exactly what the patch was going to do. Of course, it's a band-aid. Of course, it's a temporary solution to the spec. We are going to say now the same thing we said when we looked at the changes. Why is Outlaw getting this 5% buff when Assassination was in an even worse situation than Outlaw? That is kind of weird, to be honest, but at least now Outlaw has a little bit better of a performance in the raid. Talking about having not a little bit better of a performance is Augmentation, which was also nerfed. Once again, in Mythic Plus, it didn't change much for Augmentation, but now falling almost out of the top half of performers in the raid. What is also relevant, talking about changes, but to be fair, perhaps not as much in the raid, is Unholy. So the buffs to Unholy were primarily to their AoE, because it's their AoE that was buffed. So as we pointed out already, it's not that there is tons of AoE padding in the raid, so this is not really going to give Unholy a super high push in performance. And also on top of that, Unholy was already performing very well to begin with in the raid. They have been in the top 5-ish of performance in the raid for a while now, so I wouldn't put the buff to Unholy that they just received as the reason why they are now doing this well. The same and opposite can be said for Fire Mage. Fire Mage was also nerfed by 10% in AoE. But if the buff to AoE doesn't matter much to Unholy, then also the nerf to AoE doesn't matter much for Fire, at least when it comes to raiding. It will impact them a little bit more when it comes to AoE damage in Mythic Plus, as every time we say Fire Mage is being nerfed, every time we go and look at their average DPS, it still stays around 170,000. I remember the first time we looked at this, when Fire Mage was nerfed by like 7%, they had 164,000 average. And then they were nerfed by 7%. And then they spiked up to 170. Now they have just been nerfed by 10% overall damage in AoE, and they are still at 170. So for some reason, it looks like Fire Mage doesn't really care about getting nerfed and continues to have the same performance as they have been having since 10.1.5. Kind of the same can be said for Priest. Priest was also nerfed, and they are still chilling at 150k overall damage in Mythic Plus keys, which is far above many of the specs, only matched or beaten by a very select few, like Subtlety, like Enhancement, even recently, surprisingly, Beast Mastery Hunter. That is quite the increase, even though this increase for Beast Mastery definitely does not reflect itself in the raid. Beast Mastery is still towards the bottom. And on top of that, it's Marksmanship in our last patch who was buffed. So despite the nerfs, we can say Fire Mage wasn't really affected nearly as much in the raid compared to Augmentation and Shadow. Those two specs have been punished more in terms of the raid performance. The last of the things to check in terms of the changes were the nerfs to Holy Paladin, and we can already tell the effect of the nerfs that Holy Paladin received, because if we go back to 10.1.5, this was the situation for Holy Paladin, and just a few days into this set of nerfs to Holy, they have, as predicted, they have fallen below these three. Now, the surprise, which is not perhaps nearly as much of a surprise, was the fact that now they're also starting to trail behind Discipline. Now, the reason is because also there was a buff to both of the Priest specs. Holy Priest was buffed in damage, while Discipline was buffed in healing. The healing conversion of their Atonement damage went up from 36% to 40%, so effectively now their Atonement just heals 11% more, and this seems to have improved the performance of Discipline. Of course, up to this point, it's still a very, very early result, because if you look at the parses, the amount of Discipline Priests are very, very few. There are basically 1/8 of the Discipline Priests compared to the popularity of Paladin, so maybe, you know, it's more likely that only the better Discipline Priest players, the more experienced Discipline Priest players are logging right now. So maybe if we increase this number to be a flavor of the month, super popular spec, their average might go down because there are, you know, fewer good players overall playing the spec. That being said, we can at the very least still see the damage done to Holy Paladin in the raid. Once more, in Mythic Plus we don't see nearly as much the damage done to Holy Paladin, because the only real damage we will see in Mythic Plus in the near future is the fact that the majority, 99.9% of the players, want to be able to go higher than this. You know, as we mentioned already multiple times, players have been stuck at this skill level for weeks now. As a matter of fact, the reason why you don't see a rank 1 in these logs is because we have to go back to Dragonflight Season 2 before the set of changes to see a plus 30 completed. Once we go into the new patch with the Giga buffs and also the Giga nerfs to all of these specs, nobody has been able to grow even higher. So that is where you see the effect of the nerfs of these specs. You're not seeing druids being replaced by DKs, or paladins being replaced by priests, or mages being replaced by warlocks. You still see the same ones, just not able to push higher, because they just don't have the damage anymore or the defensive abilities and whatnot to stay alive, etc., etc. Where you do see the effects of the changes, as we said, is in the raid, right? In the raid, the bosses stay the same. They don't scale infinitely. They are still the same boss that we had on release, minus some nerfs that some bosses received. So we can say the nerfs and the few buffs have impacted the specs more in the raid. Holy Paladin has lost its meta Flavor of the Month status in the raid, and then back to damage, we see that both Augmentation and Shadow Priest are also doing worse, with the least affected of the trio of the Exodia comp being Fire Mage, mostly because the nerfs were to AoE, which is not that prevalent in the raid. Simultaneously, we're also seeing the growth of Discipline, which was one of the specs that was buffed in the raid, the growth of Outlaw, which was also buffed, and we see it grow in the raid. That is what is more visible after these changes, not nearly as much of an effect, at the very least for now, to the status quo of Mythic Plus, which continues to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as the mainstay specs in Mythic Plus. We have, of course, still a few more days, perhaps one more week worth of time to see some more changes, right? Some more adjustments to the meta, to see what continues to change in both Mythic Plus as well as the raid performance of the specs. But for now, this is what we have to go and look at after just a few days in terms of changes to the specs. So for today, on this Saturday, it's time to leave each other once more. We are thanking, of course, as usual, all of the Patreon supporters for the contribution and the help to the growth of the channel, which can still be given completely for free. You can like and comment down below, as well as subscribe to the channel itself. Now, with these things out of the way, thank you guys again for watching. See you guys tomorrow, I think. And in the meantime, unlucky. We have gotten up to almost midway through August with a chill temperature. Unfortunately, in the next 10 days, it's about to be tough.